Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Tessa, and today we're going to be doing some yoga for hips and lower body in our chair. Just to let you know, if you are interested in full-length practices, I do have an online studio with 30 minutes to 60-minute chair yoga practices. So this is a great opportunity to incorporate movement into your day-to-day and really experience the effects of a regular practice. If you are interested in that, check out my website, tessarayoga.com. Let's get started. We're going to be seated in our chair, feet and knees a hips width. So we're looking for the center of the knees to line up with the front iliums, not the width of the hips. And we're just going to start with tilting the pelvis, coming onto the back and the front of the sit bones. So in other words, you're tucking your tailbone under and then you're drawing your pubic bone down, feeling the back in front of the sit bones rocking on the chair. And then we're looking to commit to the middle of the sit bones, which can feel unnatural for sure. So find the middle of the sit bones, press into your feet, and then think about activating your core. So the space between the hips, drawing into center, and we're lifting the contents of the pelvic bowl up. So we're kind of creating some lightness in the hips. And then just moving through the feet a couple times, flex your feet, lift your heels a few times, keeping the contents of the pelvic bowl lifting up so we're not heavy in the pelvis, heels down and toes lifting and spreading. And then really pressing into the left foot, let's hinge the right knee a few times. And then right foot down, hinging the left knee a few times. So keeping that feeling of lifting up by pressing down into sit bones in the foot, we're going to alternate thigh lifts. And this is just like a basic warm up. All of my chair yoga classes, I include all of this movement and a little bit more for the ankles, just getting some heat and lubrication in the hip joint. So now working with the right leg, we're going to go up and out, up and in. So you have options. You can lift your knee to support it, or you can use your hip strength to move the leg. Do that a couple more times, really pushing into the left foot, really lifting up into the core. So core drawing into center and lifting up away from the sit bones. And then I'm going to take my right foot out beside, and I'm just going to pivot my hips so that my pelvis faces the center of my legs. And I'm just going to hinge at the hips now and come up. So I'm bending, I'm pulling my femurs back into my pelvis to come forward. Still lifting the core up. Few more rounds like that, keeping the neck in a neutral position. And then let's come up and step the right foot in. So left side, of course, left foot out and in. Out and in. Press into the right foot. Checking in with your breath. Are you breathing? Again, you can use the hand to support or no hand. What's feeling good for you today? Okay, now we're going to step the left foot out. We're going to square the pelvis. And then this time, let's come forward and just pause there. Think about the femur bones drawing back, the belly lifting up away from the floor and also up out of the pelvis, opening up the back of the neck. Maybe you want to even take your hands down to the feet or the floor, but keep your back straight. Something that can help us be aware of whether our back straight is straight or not is what our shoulder blades on our back are doing. Draw your scapula onto your back ribs so the heart softens a little bit and the neck remains in neutral. Bringing your hands onto your thighs, push into your hands and your feet to come up, and let's step the left foot back in. We're going to go back out to the right side. This time, coming more to the edge of the chair. Make sure your chair is solid. And I lift off my left heel and bring my foot a little wider. Now I'm going to take my left leg into internal and external rotation. Still keeping the pelvis lifting, or the core muscles of the pelvis lifting. Internal and external rotation of that left leg. So really getting into the hip. And the nice thing is that gravity is in your favor here. This left foot, there's no right or wrong placement for it. We allow the pelvis to turn with the hip. That's fine. And we just put the foot wherever so that it's no pressure in the knee. Let's try the other side. So right foot steps in, left foot steps out. We're going to pivot the hips, coming more to the edge of the chair. And now right knee falls in and out, coming off the right heel. Think about, again, you're on the middle of that left sit bone. We're really looking to avoid the arching of the lower back. Draw the belly back. Lift the pubic bone up. And then letting that right foot come down. Left foot's going to step back in. We're going to come up to stand. Feet at hips width, hands on the hips, and just circle the hips a couple times one way. And then the other way. Okay, and then we're going to step the feet out even wider. If you're unsure for a balance, be behind your chair for balance. So stepping the feet out for a wider stance, and then try again your circles. So this is going to be a little different in the hips, a little different in the groins. And really what we're looking for, this movement creates hydration in the joints, and so that's going to feel good. There's repetition, so we've got some strength and mobility. Let's go the other way. We want to be able to move our hips, but we also want strength to support that mobility. Looking for as realistic circles as we can find. So now letting the hands come to the back of the chair, we're going to start to bend one knee and then the other knee. Your feet, there's no right or wrong way for them to face. I want your weight back into your heels so that there's not like as little pressure on the knees as possible. So I'm really letting my weight be back in my heels as I bend side to side. And some of you might even be, you know, open enough to take your hands down the chair or even onto the ground. But it's not a show. It's not like, how flexible are you? Really do your best to feel that core integrated into your movement. Okay, and then we're just going to pivot those feet, walk them in towards one another. Come on and stand up. Bend your knees. We're going to step our right foot back. And then if possible, let's bring the heel down. It doesn't have to come down all the way. The heel lifting is perfectly fine. And what we're looking for is actually to find some balance here. We want the hips to be square. In fact, a better use for the chair, if you need it for balance, would be to have it beside you, because I want you to be upright. Okay, so I've got my right leg back. Heel can be on the ground or off. We're in a really high lunge. Let your right knee bend. Lift your core. Draw your tailbone down. Maybe you can take your right arm up into the air. And then really think about breathing into your back body. Breathe into your low back. Breathe into your back ribs. Doesn't look like much, but it's definitely intense. And then that right hand can come down. We're going to bend into the front knee and step that back foot forward. Coming onto the other side. So now step your left foot back. Keep your hips square. Bend your knees. Draw your tailbone down. Lift your pubic bone up. So such a long low back. You can bend into your knees. You can get a bit lower, but feel strong. Feel supported by your legs and your core strength. You can squeeze your outer hips into center. Maybe your left arm comes up beside your ear. And this is so important. Stretching out the front of the hip is great for low back. Great for the hip. Great for our posture. And then let's take the left hand down and then bend into your front knee, step it forward. And truth be told, I could keep going for an hour. You know, I'm used to doing regular long practices, but let's keep it short and sweet. We're gonna just close off our back. Let's go a bit wide with the legs. So you can go legs in line with the corners of the chair or even wider if you want, finding like more of a groin stretch. Do a couple pelvic tilts. Back of the sit bones, front of the sit bones, explore whatever it is that you're feeling in your inner hips there. Okay, and then find somewhere to stay. You can press your knees out, or maybe you're coming forward. Maybe you can press your forearms into your thighs to encourage the knees out. Again, lengthening the back of the neck and finding your scapula on your back ribs. Your shoulder blades on your upper back rather than them flaring out. Hands on your thighs, press your hands down, come on up. Toe heel those feet towards one another. Last thing here, draw the right leg in. You can hold on to your thigh and pull the knee in. If it's available to cross the ankle over the thigh, go for that. Okay, so you're either here or here. And we can release and draw in if we're crossing the ankle, or if we're hugging the knee in, we're rocking in and out. Okay, if you can cross the ankle over the knee and there's no knee pain, go for that. Right foot comes down, swap your interlace behind your left thigh, pull it in, press into the right foot. Maybe you're here and you're rocking. Maybe you're here and you're drawing the knee down and up. Nice big breaths. Relaxing your shoulders, relaxing your jaw. And letting that left foot come down. So give yourself a moment with your palms up in your lap, eyes closed, to experience the effects of your practice. How do your hips feel? How does your back feel? Is your breath different? Really be present with the sensations of the body, the energy in the body. Very often it takes energy. We have to spend energy to create more energy. So what are you feeling? Feel free to stay here as long as you like. I'm hoping you're feeling inspired to do that a little more often. If you did enjoy the practice, please give the video a thumbs up. And if you would like to see more content as I release it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you're feeling amazing. And thanks for allowing me to share my practice with you. Namaste.